Welcome, everyone. What a beautiful setting. Snoqualmie Falls, blue sky, sunshine, warm. But what an even more beautiful ride.
Yay.
Jenny Farrington. Oh, and a very handsome groom, Scott Hartley. Awesome couple. And what a fabulous group of family and friends. What could be better? Kind of reminds me of when I celebrated the wedding for Joni and Mike a few years ago. But that's another story. The story today is Jenny and Scott, a couple. And the rest of us are here just to celebrate and watch, smile, laugh, cry. We'll do all those things in this very incredible moment. This moment that transforms us, changes our names, changes our identities, and establishes even closer friendships based on love. And your love for each other is awesome. Thanks for the joy of being here with you today. This is great. And welcome again, everyone. Feel comfortable, be relaxed. There'll be a time to cheer and clap when they kiss, but that's later. And that'll be great too. So here we are. I'm a pastor, and I'd like to begin with just a brief prayer. Pray with me, please. Our loving God, we thank you for this beautiful day, for this very important moment in life that does transform us. And God, we thank you for your love and our love and the love that Jenny and Scott hold for each other in commitment. Now, Lord, bless us to be a blessing. Help us to relax and know your spirit and to be comfortable in this very special setting. And all God's people said, amen. And now for the big question. Scott, do you stand by Jenny, ready to commit yourself to her in the bond of marriage? And do you affirm your desire to be her husband and expressing from this day forth your deepest love and respect and a growing relationship of tenderness and understanding of selves?
I do.
I do.
And Jenny, do you stand by Scott, ready to commit yourself to him in the bond of marriage? And do you affirm your desire to be his wife and expressing from this day forth your deepest love and respect and a growing relationship of tenderness and understanding of self? Say, I do.
I do.
And parents, to all of you, give your blessing to both Jenny and Scott as they enter the relationship of marriage of self. Say, we do.
We do.
We do.
And now, do all of you, as extended family and friends, also give your blessing to Scott and Jenny as they enter the relationship of marriage? If so, shout out, we do.
We do.
Awesome. Thank you. You may be seated. Scott and Jenny, you gave me a beautiful poem, a prayer to read. And it goes like this. I asked God for a flower, and he gave me a bouquet. I asked God for a minute, and he gave me this day. I asked God for true love, and he gave me that too. And I asked God for an angel, and he gave me you. That's a great group of words. And another group of words is found in Scripture, in the Bible, what's often called the love chapter. The Apostle Paul wrote to his friends in Rome these words. After describing all the qualities of love, he said, in this, we have three lasting qualities in life: faith, hope, and love. But the greatest of these is love. Painful irritants and a relationship and bring healing and hope. Scott and Jenny, some irritating things will enter your relationship. They will, and when they do, make some pearls. Remember how pearl is spelled. Each of the five letters in the word, there are two words. P provide and pursue. Provide for each other, pursue each other. E for engage and encourage. Engage each other intimately and encourage each other fully. A for attract and affirm. You are attracted and you affirm each other. Keep on doing it. R for respect and romanticize. Respect and romanticize. And L for learn and love. And there might be a couple other L's. Laughter is one. Keep on laughing and keep on listening. Listening to each other. Well, that's how you spell pearl. And that's how you make a pearl in marriage. And I've got a pearl for you. It's my wedding card. And I glued it to a treasure chest. And it's got everything I just said written on the inside. And on the outside it says, here are the healing ingredients for making a pearl. Say, after you blew it, I love you. I'm sorry. You are precious to me. I apologize. I forgive you. Hey, I take my part of the blame. I will make it right. I will listen. I will be patient. And I believe there's healing in our relationship to make a pearl. So, Scott, you can take that, put it in your pocket, and when Jenny irritates you, put it on the table and say, let's talk, let's listen, let's forgive. And likewise, Jenny, you'll know where it is. When he irritates you, put it on the table and say, let's talk, let's make a pearl, let's take time out, let's fall in love all over again and make something very precious come out of this moment. Well, that's enough of me. We want to hear your promise, your commitment. And we as family and friends also make a promise. We're here for you. We'll be here for you in the future. We'll root for you. So pass your bouquet over to Stephanie and hold on for dear life. And I'll hold the rings for you as you hold each other. Oh, and repeat after me. You ready?
Ready.
All right, Scott, here we go. I, Scott, take you, Jenny, to be my wife.
I, Scott, take you, Jenny, to be my wife.
My enduring friend, my faithful partner, and my eternal love.
My enduring friend, my faithful partner, and my eternal love.
With this ring, I give you my heart.
With this ring, I give you my heart.
From this day forward, you will not walk alone.
From this day forward, you will not walk alone.
And I promise to live in the warmth of your heart.
And I promise to live in the warmth of your heart.
And always call it home.
And always call it home.
Likewise, Jenny. Saying these words first, I, Jenny, take you, Scott, to be my husband.
I, Jenny, take you, Scott, to be my husband.
My enduring friend, my faithful partner, and my eternal love.
My enduring friend, my faithful partner, and my eternal love.
With this ring, I give you my heart.
With this ring, I give you my heart.
From this day forward, you will not walk alone.
From this day forward, you will not walk alone.
And I promise to live in the warmth of your heart.
And I promise to live in the warmth of your heart.
And always call it home.
And always call it home.
Friends, let's pray together. Our loving God, we thank you that you are the source of love and that we get to experience it and share it and make promises to be committed. Lord, bless Jenny. Bless Scott, their family, their loved ones. And may their love continue to grow. And Lord, bless them with pearls, those precious things that remind them how precious they are for each other. And Lord, we thank you for this great place, this great opportunity to be here, to experience their commitment, their promises, their vows of life together, and the gifts that they exchange. And all God's people said, amen.
Amen.
Well, we've done it. It's a joy to pronounce now that as a minister in the Church of Jesus Christ, I pronounce you husband and wife. And before they kiss and go up to the reception, we want to invite all of you to the great party up in the terraces after we conclude. Now as they kiss, let's applaud and cheer, shall we?